if you see in the movie The Empire Strikes Back, when Luke Skywalker gets his replacement hand, he controls it with his brain, giving him exactly the same function that he had before he lost his hand. That's the most amazing technology. That's an example of the kind of technology that we're hoping to develop. The thing that I like most about what I'm working on is its potential to improve the quality of life for so many different people who are affected by disorders where their brain and their body no longer communicate. The new technology that I'm developing uses light to record and decode brain activity and is both non-invasive enough for patients, but gives us enough information to build better brain-machine interfaces. This technology has the potential to give sight back to the blind, hearing back to the deaf, and movement back to people who have lost it due to losing a limb or undergoing some kind of traumatic brain injury. I got interested in neuroscience through an experience I had outside of the lab. I lived in Rwanda for almost a year, and while I was there, I got very interested in understanding how the brain changes when people experience extreme trauma. My entire life changed in Rwanda. I also met my husband there. So many people in science have this idea that you need to spend all of your waking hours in the lab in order to be a good scientist. And I don't think that's true. I feel like becoming a mom has actually made me a better scientist. The people who make the best scientists are people who are curious, people who are fearless, and people who are determined. And anyone who has a toddler might also recognize that description. I almost left science when I had my son because I couldn't find very many positive stories about mom scientists. I want to be the story that I was looking for.